With over 1,100 plus entertainment industry guests and over 5.5 million viewers, live from the Pepper J Production Studios in Hollywood, California, it's the ActorsE Chat Show. Our guest today is a model and a producer of shows such as More Horror in Hollywood and Ion Entertainment, for which she won an EOTM Award for Outstanding Talk Show Host. She is a TV and film actress. Please welcome Dawna Lee Heising and our ActorsE host, Ron Brewington.
Hi, everybody, and welcome to ActorsE Charts. I'm Ron Brewington, and it's a Friday, and we're having a hot time here in California. A little fire's here, a little fire's there. But all in all, everyone's having a good time here in California. Hope that you'll come out and see us. Today, we've got a very, very special guest today. And when I first read her biography, I was overwhelmed because the lady's got, she does it all. You'll hear some of the things she gets into. But it is with great pleasure that I introduce to you Dawna Lee Heising.
Yeah. Thank you
welcome,
so much.
Welcome.
What a great intro.
No, and listen, what a great lady. What can I tell you? As I said, you do so much. So there has to be a beginning, a middle, and an end. How did it start for you?
Well, I first have to start, I think, with education, because that's the backbone of everything. I went to UC Berkeley for a year, and then I went to probably every junior college in Orange County. I got an AA in drama from Cypress College and an AS in chemistry. Mm-hmm. And from there, I went on to Pepperdine and I got a bachelor's and a master's, or MBA.
Mm-hmm. And there's one more other degree you got?
I have a PhD in marketing, too.
That's a PhD. Dr. Heising, if you will. Dr. Heising.
Oh, but I never use that. My daughter's a real doctor.
Is there a doctor in the house? Well, again, you got into the business, and when did you first get into the business, ma'am?
Well, actually, it was a long time ago. Mm-hmm. I was in a lot of... I'm a very obsessive person, as anyone who knows me can tell you. While I went to UC Berkeley, I entered the Miss San Francisco Universe pageant, and I won that, and someone saw me, and I became Miss Hawaii I guessed it as Miss Hawaii on Fantasy Island, mm-hmm. and that's where it started, and then I left school, and that's when I went to the JC, but I started my film career here.
So your film career, actually right here in Hollywood, you started.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. What were some of the early roles that you had?
Let's see. I played... Now, I have to tell you, I'm a mother and a wife, so I don't do nudity, but I'm Eurasian, too. So mm-hmm. I've played a lot of prostitute roles because in my earlier life, mm-hmm. that's what Asians played.
Yes.
And I loved it because it was so different from me, and we got to dress in mm-hmm. all these sexy clothes. So I played a prostitute in Blade Runner. Mm-hmm. I wore a green dress, and it was the scene where Daryl Hannah's doing the backflips.
Right, I remember that. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I think I got cut out. But anyway, I was in that.
Mm-hmm.
The biggest role that I had was playing the Snake Woman on Magnum P.I.
Ah, who's that? Well, who's that guy who was a star of that show? Tom Selleck.
Yes.
Uh-huh. What a guy. Yeah.
Yeah. That, mm-hmm. Well, actually, I never got to meet him.
What?
I played Cleo the snake dancer, and uh-huh. so I had to dance with a snake. And we couldn't, and the reason why they cast it here is because they didn't.
There is, back in the old
days.
Yeah,
oh, that's right.
That's Thomas, yeah.
Yeah. So they couldn't bring snakes into Hawaii, so mm-hmm. I had a trainer off stage, and I danced with a snake here.
Hmm, sounds like fun. What kind of dance did you do, a two-step, a waltz?
Well, dance. I mean, he was wrapped around my neck.
But that was a lot of fun.
Yeah, that was
occasion.
Great.
Indeed.
Uh-huh.
So how many movies have you done so far?
I've got 81 credits, but
wow.
they're not all movies. Those are web series and TVs, mm-hmm. TV shows.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, I came back. I took a break for a while, and I was a marketing director in technology. I've started 4 marketing departments myself since I do have an MBA.
Okay.
So I know a lot about ERP software, you know, disk drives. So I did take a break, but I came back 3 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
Since then, I've done over 40 projects.
40 projects,
yeah.
My goodness.
It's a completely different atmosphere now than when I first started, because...
Different in which way?
When I first started, mm-hmm. you really only had, which was, like I keep saying, a long time ago, you only had the three networks, and then you had the big studios. Mm-hmm. So if you look at the bottom of my IMDb page, and, you know, some people have told me maybe I should take some off so people don't know my real age, but I'm proud of all of them,
Thank you, Lord, let you live these many years. Hey, nothing wrong with that.
Yeah, so anyway, but you'll see that if you look at the bottom of my IMDb, mm-hmm. everybody will have heard of all of the shows or movies that I was in. Mm-hmm. Now, at the top, it's kind of a different atmosphere. I've been in a lot of indie films where mm-hmm. you may not have heard of the filmmaker or the film, but I still think you have to be very talented in order to get a film made.
Okay.
You may not have heard of some of those, but you will if I have any say in it because I do PR too.
I see that you got a couple of them still pending or some other things, pre-production?
Yeah.
Some?
Actually,
yeah.
Okay. I do have a lot pending.
Thank you for rolling that. Thank you. Mm-hmm. Give us a chance to see what IMDb is all about. For those who are not in the business, IMDb is a good source of information about people in the business, their production, things they've done. Very good mm-hmm. way. Whenever I do this show or whatever, I talk to some actress whenever I'm doing an interview, I always go to IMDb. Plug for IMDb. Go ahead, IMDb.
Okay? Oh, I love IMDb.
Indeed, indeed. Who are some of your favorite actors and actresses that you've met along the way?
I have so many. I love Bill Oberst Jr., mm-hmm. and I was just telling Pepper, I'm on Slated now. Bill is attached to every project that comes on there. He won a Daytime Emmy for mm-hmm. Take This Lollipop. I've done 5 interviews with him for either Ion Entertainment or More Horror. Mm-hmm. But, I mean, he's a fantastic actor and the nicest person in the world. I love Gregory Blair. I first met him because he's an award-winning screenwriter.
Yes, ma'am.
And he has a degree from Cambridge. So I knew he was brilliant, but I had no idea how funny he is, because I just cast him in this film that we're doing called Natural Born Filmmaker from Steve Oakley. There he is.
Yeah.
I cast him as one of the filmmakers in it. He is so funny. And, I mean, he practically steals the movie, and so mm-hmm. Steve's writing a bigger role for him because he's so great. And then also, Gregory and I are planning on doing another film after that because I was just so impressed. I love him. You said actors or actresses?
Either or.
Okay.
Get them all in there.
Okay. Well, you know, I mean, I have favorite filmmakers because I work really closely with the filmmakers. I'm meeting with Vita Kafari today. She's the one who told me about ActorsE.
Okay.
And she's going to be in Circus of Dread.
Thank you, Vita.
With me.
Talk about ActorsE chat, please. Keep it up.
Well, yeah, actually, she knows I'm on here.
Yes, I hope she's watching.
So, yeah, hopefully she's watching, or at least she'll share the link. Vita is one of the leads in Circus of Dread, along with Bill Oberst Jr.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Let's see. Anyone in horror.
It's a few.
A lot of them. Everyone I've cast.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
Yeah.
You know, because I only cast people that I really like mm-hmm. or that I know are talented, that I know can roll with the punches, mm-hmm. you know, that can... deal with anything that happens on the set, because with indie films, anything can happen.
Right, anything
yeah,
can happen,
people
yes.
cannot show up, mm-hmm. and then you. Oh, I can't forget Domiziano Arcangeli.
Yes. Uh-huh.
Oh my God! Oh, Domiziano Arcangeli is a natural born filmmaker.
Mm-hmm.
I play his wife, and also Aki Aliong is one mm-hmm. of my favorites. Mm-hmm. He's doing a film now with Jean-Claude Van Damme, and he's away for 3 months. But I play his wife in Pass.
Good to hear about Claude Van Damme still working. Yeah, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Yes, I mean, he's like one of the top mm-hmm. Actors internationally.
Yes, yes.
So that's a big deal for Aki. I'm trying to get Aki onto ActorsE. And then I'm also playing Bill Oberst's wife in a film called Camp of the Damned. Bill is going to be awesome in that film. Mm-hmm. So my new goal now... besides getting larger roles, I really do want larger roles this year. Because after Salvation of One, which I'll tell you about,
mm-hmm.
but after playing Dommy's wife and Bill's wife mm-hmm. and Aki's wife, Now I want to be the wife of everyone that I admire on screen. So that really is a goal of mine now.
Okay. Play a lot of wives then.
Yeah, I want to.
not a girlfriend, just got to play the wife.
Yeah, yeah, well, actually, I've played a lot of girlfriends. And uh-huh. Like I said, a lot of hookers.
And it's fun. There he is. Who's that handsome young man?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yes.
He cleans up well. I mean, because a lot of times you see him covered in blood.
Okay. You're watching Actors E-Chat. I'm your host, Ron Brewington. We'll be right back after a word from one of our sponsors. The great thing about NNOW Media is it's a one-stop shop. We are soup to nuts. We have writers, directors, producers, animators, motion graphics artists, editors, videographers, musicians, all under one roof. And we are a boutique creative house where we actually do the creative at much more affordable price and have the staff in-house to execute it professionally. My name is John Palacio.
My name is Luis Montez.
My name is Paul Robinson.
I am Jesse Cervantes.
I'm Curtis Peel.
My name is Ben Joran.
One of the most common questions we have from potential clients is, how does it work? What happens when you engage NNOW Media to create a video, a marketing campaign?
It first starts with, you know, obviously having the phone conversation with the client, brainstorm with them to come up with a really good concept and a really good idea to push whatever they're trying to do to the next level.
Only with that in mind can we really try to tailor a concept and a script for their exact audience that fits in with their branding and the message they want to tell.
I will storyboard it out, get a real rough idea of what we want to do.
We'll then present the client with a couple of options, different ways that we could go with some of the things that we've come up with.
And they'll say, this is good, and then we'll come back and we'll start animating that or designing it or editing it.
Our clients are generally, you know, like to be really hands-on, and we'd like to hear from you kind of all along the board. There's no surprises.
What we like to do with every partner is we actually create a page on the NNOW website.
So they can give feedback, and that way, when the time we get to the final product, you know, usually there's not a whole lot more revisions to do because we've already been working together the whole time.
The big difference is that real personal creative touch.
We have a creative group that can execute that vision, whether it's animation, video, motion graphics, and do so with some unique creative that is custom tailored to that business.
You know, dream it up. It's video. It's magic. It can happen.
And welcome, everybody. Welcome back. I'm Ron Brewington, and you're watching Actors E-Chat. By the way, we want you to tune into our sister channel. We call it ActorsReporter.com. And if you do, you'll get a chance to get the latest news, interviews, commentary, as well as click on the discount links to all of our wonderful, wonderful sponsors. That's ActorsReporter.com. Trust me, you'll be glad that you did. Okay? We're coming back at you now. We've got a wonderful guest today. Her name is Dawna Lee Heising. She's an actor, she's a producer, she's a mother, she's a wife, she's a lot of things. Before we went to the break, we were talking about being an actor or actress in this town. Talk about, if you will, the competition that goes into getting work in this town.
Well, obviously there's tons of competition, and especially for people that are the same type. I think because of the competition, and there's so many talented people in this town, I think, you know, I really believe in the secret and the psychology of winning. I believe that there's enough work for everyone in this town, but I do believe that you have to stay positive and you have to stay nice, and that the good things come to the people who are nice and positive, but who also prepare. And I think, like I said, the background of everything mm-hmm. is a good education and is in knowing what you're doing. I mean, you have to, there's so much competition in this town. If anyone asked me what I would recommend to young people coming here, it would be to get an education. And it doesn't even matter what your education is in, just so that you're well-rounded and so that you know about the world and you're ready to face the competition in any industry. Mm-hmm. I mean, there's tons in the film industry, but there's also tons in business. But if you come into the film industry, you do need to know how to act, because the casting directors can tell right away. And you're going against people with bachelors. If you go to theater, practically everyone has a master's. You know, so you're going against people who know what they're doing. So you can't just come here with a pretty face and think that you're going to get discovered. I mean, I guess that could happen. It happened. I've heard it happened to Lana Turner.
Yes.
Or Marilyn Monroe.
Monroe,
you know,
yes.
But I mean, these yes. days, I do really think you have to be talented.
How about doing stage work? Do you recommend an actor do stage work?
Stage work is the best. I personally don't have time anymore because I'm the vice president of a software company, too. Mm-hmm. So I don't have time to do stage, but it's the best for anyone. It's the best training ground. You have to know what you're doing. You have to know about voice. I was with the Friends and Artists Theater for 12 mm-hmm. years, and I actually started with Sal Romeo. I played May Lee in Flower Drum Song, and mind you, I can't sing. May Lee has two solos in Flower Drum Song, so I took singing lessons to play her, you know, and I have to say I didn't sing that well. But anyway, I got the role, and it's the best training ground in the world. Mm-hmm. And it helps you get over your fears of being on stage. It helps you cry on cue. It helps you get those feelings inside.
That's right, the studio, yes. Mm-hmm. Okay. And people need that because,
you know, I think so.
There's no take two. There's no take three. It's mm-hmm. take one.
Yes,
and
live.
That's it.
Like here.
For folks, we're coming at you live in case you didn't know. This is live. There is one aspect of acting. It's the sore subject for a lot of people. Auditions. What do you think about auditions?
Well, I probably have a different view of auditions. Maybe not. But it's different for me because I live in Huntington Beach.
Okay.
So every time I come to Los Angeles where the auditions are, it seems to take longer and longer. I came back to the business 3 years ago. Mm-hmm. When I first came back, it took me an hour to get to Los Angeles.
Wow.
So that's like an hour to get here, another half hour to
Who's that fella in the movie there?
Oh, that's LeJean. and that was me in Teacher's Day, and I won a Best Actress Award for that role.
Congratulations.
So LeJean plays my boyfriend.
Uh-huh, okay.
And that was from Jared Masters, and I need to talk about Jared.
Please.
He's the reason. Well, you know, first I didn't finish about auditions.
Uh-huh.
It's just really difficult. Okay, because I just came up to do an interview on Monday. It took me 3 hours to get to Sherman Oaks. So when I come to an audition, I'm already frazzled before I get into the audition. And then you go to the audition, and you know, if you're a trained actor or actress, mm-hmm. you're prepared for the audition. So right. that's not really the hard part. For me, it's getting here. But luckily, I'm working with some really great filmmakers now, so mm-hmm. I don't really have to audition that. I shouldn't say that. I don't audition as much as I used to because
they know you.
I know
talent.
People.
Yes,
yeah.
Yes, they know people. Yes, definitely. Understand that you have made other things that you got into. You were a swimsuit model for many, many years, I'm told.
Yeah, that came from the pageants, too. Uh-huh. Or I don't know if it did. I got into both at the same time. But I've been a bikini model for a long time. I started with Eugenia and Venus mm-hmm. swimwear, and I'm not even sure if they're around anymore. But now I'm still, like, that was a January cover.
Okay.
That was January 2014.
Wow.
So I'm in Bikini Magazine. That wow. was in Supermodels Magazine.
Mm. So, you look
yeah,
good,
I'm
lady.
Still,
you look good. Looking
oh, thank
good.
You.
Mm-hmm. As we call it, G-double-O-D. You look
oh,
good.
Oh, and I miss Short Flicks International.
Yes,
That's Steve Miraband's company.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a web company, and it helps you build your brand equity and your PR.
Okay.
Steve's
okay.
been great to me. That was from a calendar, the Miss Bikini Challenge calendar.
All right.
That, I was Miss March.
Okay.
And that was the cover of the calendar.
You photograph very well. Good photography.
Thank you.
There. Definitely. One of the things that, and we'll just take a moment to talk about this, you've been in a couple of beauty contests, I'm told.
Yes, I said I'm very obsessive. So I've been over probably 100 contests in my life, mostly when I was younger. And it got to be like my passion. I mean, I was in one practically every weekend. And there are different kinds of pageants. Mm-hmm. There are the ones that take talent and where you really have to have brains. And then there were the swimsuit ones where you just come down, walk down the runway in your swimsuit. Mm-hmm. I did both when I was younger.
Mm-hmm. Okay. I'm glad that you brought that up because for a period of time in my life, I was a judge in training at beauty pageants. And what you say is so true because I used to watch the young ladies. They have to come in there and do the makeup, the clothing. They have to change the clothing. They have to make be good with the judges, or get over with the judges. And mm-hmm. it was like almost like, I won't say a business, but it was really a business. It was what you did.
It is a business.
Indeed.
I mean, I have to say, after mm-hmm. doing so many, I got to be really good at it.
Mm-hmm.
I won most of them or was first runner-up, but it's something, you know, and then I stopped for a while, but I just came back recently, and I do certain things, like I miss Sort Flicks,
yes.
because I want to publicize Sort Flicks.
Yes.
For Steve.
Okay. All right. You're watching ActorsE Chat. I'm your host, Ron Brewington. We'll be back in a moment after a word from one of our sponsors.
Over her long career, Nina Fosh appeared in classic films such as Spartacus, The Ten Commandments, and An American in Paris. She received an Academy Award nomination for her performance in Robert Wise's Executive Suite. In 1965, Nina Fosh arrived here at USC to begin teaching directing, and I was lucky enough to get into one of her first classes. Even as she continued acting in film and television, Nina's passion for teaching lasted for over 40 years. Her course was immensely popular because she developed her own unique style, drawing on her experiences studying with Lee Strasberg, Stella Adler, and Uta Hagen, and being directed by such icons as Vincent Minnelli, Stanley Kubrick, Cecil B. DeMille, and Otto Preminger. As I began directing, the tremendous value of her teachings became evident and how important it was to preserve them for future generations. We became close friends, and at a cinema department event, we ran into my former classmate, George Lucas, who invited us up to Skywalker Ranch, where we discussed creating a DVD of her course. He agreed to finance it, and on January 10th, 2002, we began taping an entire semester using a crew of USC film students. We filmed for 8 hours a week for 15 weeks, and this is the result.
Okay, so what are we going to do this semester?
And welcome back. You're watching ActorsE Chat. I'm your host, Ron Brewington. And I want to ask you, please, if you would please check out our sister website. It's called actorsreporter.com. Now, myself, I work here, and I can't wait to get an opportunity to see this week after week or daily because it gives me and you a chance to see the latest news, interviews, commentary, as well as click on the discount links to all of our wonderful, wonderful sponsors. So again, that's actorsreporter.com. You'll be glad you did it. Okay. My special guest today is Dawna Lee Heising. She's an actress, she's a model, she's a producer, she's a lot of things. Dawna Lee, tell me this. How do you stay in the good shape that you're in?
Oh, well, thank you. Actually, now I'd like to say that for the last 3 years, I've been taking pole dancing. I mean, I used to use all the machines. My house looks like a gym. I've got, like, a treadmill. I've got a bicycle. I've got one of those things where you do pull-ups.
Uh-huh.
I've got, my daughter used to be a pole vaulter, so I've got this contraption where you pull yourself up. I've got everything in the house, but for the last 3 years, oh, that's a pole dancing video that I did for the film Roberto. And that's when I first started pole dancing, so that was, oh my gosh, so that was before I could climb or invert. I can do those things now,
uh-huh.
but I do take pole dancing now, and I love it.
Oh.
The classes are an hour and 15 minutes,
mm-hmm.
and I want to say that I'm playing a pole dancer in Jared Masters' next movie called Passion Show.
Okay.
Jared is a brilliant young filmmaker.
I've heard his name.
He's only 26 years
mm-hmm.
old. I've done 3 films with him, and
there
I won. Oh, Jared. Hi, Jared. Hello, Jared. And actually, he's been on this show. I brought him on with me. Mm-hmm. But he's fantastic. I won a Best Actress Award for Jared's Teacher's Day. Slink. He won Best Horror Film at the EOTM Awards for Slink, which is the first one I did with him. I'm doing, Deadly Punkettes is coming up.
Okay.
And I play Gladys Kang in that.
Right.
I'm going to be playing a beauty queen title holder named Shelby in his next one called Passion Show. And then we've got two more coming up. We've got Ballerina Massacre and Carny Girls. And I'm still, we're still looking to get those funded. So if there are any investors out there, you know, I'd love to hear from you.
She'd like to hear from you. You can bring those checks with you.
Oh, there's Deadly Punkettes. That's coming out soon.
Okay.
And then we're filming Passion Show next.
Okay. Finish this sentence for me. Donnelly Heising is?
Donnelly Heising, what I'd like it to be, is Donnelly Heising is a good wife, a good daughter, a good mother, a great mother. a great actress.
All right.
Because I've worked really hard on it, you know, especially, I was in theater for 12 years, but I'd like to be a great wife, too, as long as I'm going to say that.
Hey,
great everything.
Like right, be
you know,
great.
But,
Have you had to overcome any barriers in this town? Anything you had to overcome?
Yes, actually, I have.
Please.
I think a lot because of my voice, and because of the roles that I play, or because of the roles that I get cast in. I think, and because my hair is blonde now, it used to be dark, I think maybe I have had to get over the perception of being a dumb blonde, which I definitely am not.
PhD, folks. PhD.
Yeah, I'm not a real blonde either. I'm Chinese, Japanese, and, you know, American Indian. Okay. My uncle is Tak Fujimoto, who is the DP on Silence of the Lambs. I have a cousin named David Wong, who won an Emmy for Peter and the Wolf on Broadway. So, I mean, I'm Asian. And Asians stress education.
Yes, yes.
So I think, I really do think that maybe I've had to overcome that barrier, but I feel like in the last year I have, thanks to some wonderful people in this town who have given me really great roles, including a filmmaker named Chandra Gerson. Mm-hmm. And Chandra is fantastic, and we're filming her first feature film called Book of Choices.
Okay.
But we just finished filming, it's got three short stories in it. I was one of the leads in the third short story called Salvation of One. We just finished shooting that. It was the best role that I've had to date. I had to play a mother in it, and I can cry in cue. It's really easy for me to cry, but I don't like conflict.
I'm not going to ask you to do it right now.
I don't like conflict at all.
Okay.
I mean, I tend to run away from it, and this woman had to be really angry and really powerful and bring all of those different emotions. So I studied for it for a year with Chandra and with an acting coach called June Barfield so that I would be able to bring the power and intensity that I needed to the role of Honora Turner in Salvation of One. And Chandra seems to be really happy with my performance, and she's tough to please, believe me. Mm. So I can't wait to see the film when it comes out.
Do you like television over film or film over television? Which one do you like better?
It's different. You know, these days, I've been in tons and tons of indie films, and so I love them because I know, oh, there's Chandra! She's a blonde nail like me.
Is it true blondes have more fun?
No, I think brunettes can have fun too. I've
been and the redheads.
I had tons of fun as a brunette.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So what was I saying?
You were talking about how you got along, some of the hurdles you had to overcome in this town.
Oh,
and how,
okay.
How the family, the education.
Oh, and then, you know, playing a prostitute and playing a pole dancer, which I love. Mm-hmm. I mean, I love playing those roles because they're sexy and they're fun, and I get to dress sexy, and they're so different from me. Mm-hmm. But there comes a time where you just want to do larger roles. I mean, I've paid my dues.
Yes, ma'am.
I've done so many films now that really my goal this year, besides to play the wife of everyone that I admire, you know, is to do larger roles.
Larger roles.
You know, mm-hmm. And actually, I want to end my career with leading parts. So,
right.
You know, I'm telling Jared, you know, to write a part for me. I'm begging Mark Savage, who's another filmmaker that I work with, mm-hmm. to write a part for me, you know. If anyone needs a person like me, and I can act, you know, for a lead, I'd love to meet with you.
Okay. Let's go to something a little bit personal. You have a very special interest in cardiovascular disease. Can you tell us why?
Well, actually, my grandfather died of heart disease.
Sorry.
And when that happened, I mean, he lived to an older age, so it was good. But since then, I've just discovered that so many people at young ages these days seem to have hardening of the arteries really, really young. And I don't know if it's the diets that we have or the stress,
mm-hmm.
but because of that, you know, I want to tell people that it's so easy to prevent. I think we've pretty much eradicated smoking,
yep.
which is one of the causes. But really, if you exercise and if you eat the right foods, which maybe in America, I think we're beginning to realize that. My daughter is a pharmaceutical rep for Santa Fe Aventis, and she works for a diabetes drug. So a lot of the same things that cause diabetes cause heart disease. You know, and the same thing is our diets and not getting enough exercise. And I think America is known as the meat and potatoes country, but really, meat is really bad for you. It can have nitrates in it,
mm-hmm.
And it's got tons of fat. So I just think people really need to watch what they eat and exercise.
Right. Thank you for that advice. I know you give back because you're a member of the American Heart Association and a few other organizations.
Yeah, actually, I work for the Heart Gala,
mm-hmm.
and luckily, my husband's business partner. My husband is a financial planner, and he's been listed as one of the top 50 wealth managers in Los Angeles magazine for the past 3 years.
Mm-hmm.
And he used to be a VP of marketing for ConAgra. He introduced the Healthy Choice food line. So there's a plug for my husband.
Go,
he teaches.
Go Paul.
He teaches financial planning.
Yes.
At UCLA, and he teaches marketing at Chapman University in his spare time, which he has none. But
gotcha.
Anyway, his partner's wife makes jewelry, and she donates jewelry for the Heart Gala. So thank you, Beth Moran. And Beth also gave me a necklace, which I wore in Book of Choices or Salvation of One,
mm-hmm.
and she's going to get a credit for the necklace.
Outstanding. Mm-hmm. It's wonderful when people do a lot of work, particularly when it comes to health issues. And again, thank you for that advice. A medical problem, we all have medical problems. I know myself, I'm a double prostate cancer survivor. I had it twice, and only through the grace of God am I still here. And I go, like you, I go around and talk to people. I like to give back and talk to people about these diseases. And they need a reminder, particularly coming from a celebrity such as yourself. When you say it, I hope that people will listen. Because again, having a regular physical after you get to a certain age, dieting, like you say, the food that we eat, the exercising, we don't take that for real until it's too late. Until it's too late.
Do you take saw palmetto?
No, I don't have no need to do it anymore because my prostate is gone.
Congratulations. That's good to hear.
But I'm very, very, I know I work with a guy here in this town. I'm going to give a plug to him if they don't mind. His name is Dr. Fred Parrott, had an organization called Real Men Cook Foundation. And what it was all about was, again, he's a medical doctor, OBGYN type, but he had prostate cancer. His father had it. He died. And people, they need to understand, prostate, particularly African-American men, prostate cancer is the number one killer of African-American men. So again, in certain ethnic groups, there's certain diseases that come for certain people. You have to make yourself aware of it. In today's world, like you say, with the education, computers, all the good things we got, there's no way where you should not know everything about anything. You should know about it. But when you hear it coming from you, Dawna, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. You mentioned Paul. Let's talk about Paul. Let's talk about Paul Heising. Tell us about Paul, please.
First, I'll say he's the most humble person in the world, and he would be really mad if he knew that I was plugging him
plug
so much.
But it's okay.
I think I probably, you know, already said, actually, he was a fantastic business person.
Oh, there he is. Yeah, there he is.
Oh, yeah. There's my husband.
Hi, Paul.
Yeah, that was taken in my living room, actually. No, my dining room. But okay. He's learning about cameras, too. Mm-hmm. Paul works all the time. He works for a company called Moran, Kimura, and Heising. And I already said that he's listed as one of the top 50 wealth managers. He's one of the few people who has switched careers in midlife and mm-hmm. has been successful at both careers.
Outstanding. There he is. Yes, there. That's another little biography on him.
Okay. Yes. Yeah, it's Moran, Kimura, and Heising. Mm-hmm. This is his second career, and he's extremely successful at it, but he mm-hmm. works harder than anyone I know.
And then the rest of your family, you got two beautiful daughters, Melissa and Mindy.
Marissa and Misty.
Misty.
And
uh-huh.
Marissa is a pharmaceutical rep for Sanofi Aventis. Okay. She is fantastic in her field. Mm-hmm. She came in recently in the top 15% of sales reps for Sanofi Aventis, which is based in France, and it's one of the largest drug companies in the world.
Okay.
So that shows you how great she is at sales. She also, she has two beautiful daughters, so I have two granddaughters.
You're a grandmother?
Yes. They're,
wow, that's
I don't
a pretty
mention,
grandmother.
I don't mention it on my Facebook page because I don't mention my
understand.
Family.
It's understand. Just for... Understand. Hey, there you go. There you
oh,
go.
Yeah. There's there that's, you go. That's Marissa and Sammy and Emmy and Maya.
Oh,
and Emmy is four and Maya is 1.5.
All right.
So I'm still waiting for my boy.
Grandson, yeah.
So Misty's under a lot of pressure. Marissa is a great salesperson.
Yes.
Misty is my youngest.
Okay.
And she was a Fulbright scholar. She spent a year in Japan doing research.
Yes.
And she's now a doctor at UCLA. She got her undergraduate degree at UCLA, mm-hmm. and she went to Albany Medical College.
All right.
And she was just recently voted chief.
There she is.
Oh, there's Misty.
There she is, Misty.
Yeah, and she was just recently mm-hmm. voted chief resident, which is a huge honor.
Wow. I know you and Paul are very, very proud of your children.
Oh, they're yeah. We're so proud.
Yeah.
They both were soccer standouts, and Misty okay. was also a pole vaulter.
Pole vaulter?
Yeah, a
didn't
champion pole vaulter.
Didn't you mention that a little earlier?
Yeah. It's okay. helped me in pole dancing okay. because she left her machine to me.
All right. Okay. You're watching ActorsE Eat Chat. I'm your host, Ron Brewington. We'll be right back after a word from one of our sponsors.
Hey, everyone. I am Judith Jones. If you are looking for photographs, which a lot of you are, let's face it, we need photographs every day. Actors, models, even if you're just, you know, the milkman, you need photographs, okay? You need to look good. And if you want to look good, you've only got one man to go to, and that's John Michael Ferrari. You see, I needed to look good. So I went to John, and he basically took me to the most beautiful place in LA and took these wonderful photographs of me, and I really didn't even recognize myself because I just looked, well, let's just face it, I looked stunning. So if you want to look stunning like myself in those photographs, go to him. He will make you look beautiful. If you're pretty, he'll make you look prettier. If you're not pretty, he'll make you look pretty. John Michael Ferrari. That's all you need to know. So go to imagesbyferrari.com. That's the website, imagesbyferrari.com. And you can check out all his photography and you can contact him there. You can look at a picture of me. He directed me, because if you need direction, which, hello, I do, he directs you too. So go and check that out, imagesbyferrari.com. You'll love it. You'll look great. Check it out. Bye, everyone.
And welcome back to ActorsE Chat. I'm Ron Brewington, your host, and with me this very lovely lady, Dawna Lee Heising. You've got some movies coming up. Tell us about them, please.
Okay, well, I would really like to talk about the movies. I already mentioned Jared Masters and how important he is to me. Mm-hmm. I have Carney Girls, Ballerina Massacre, and Passion Show coming up with Jared, and hopefully many more. I do have Circus of Dread coming up with filmmaker Mark Savage.
This year, 2014?
No, actually 2015.
Okay.
It's a big budget movie, so He's got Mark has half of the budget in. He's got it half financed, so we just need finishing funds for that film. And that's starring Bill Oberst Jr. I'm playing the snake woman in the movie, so I have one of the leads in it. Mark is one of my best friends. And he has Pond Scum that's going to be released. I played a small role as Abby in that, and in that movie, maybe I shouldn't say, but anyway.
Can you give us a little tease about what to expect?
I'll tell you, because it's a small role. I got raped and murdered.
Okay.
In Pond Scum. I'd like to talk about a film called Happy Ending, and I'm really excited about that one. Mm-hmm. It was written by Phil Condit, and it's being produced by Maria Olson, who is one of the biggest names in horror. And it's a comedy horror film, and it's about this creature that comes and kills a lot of people. Mm-hmm. But I'm playing, that's Maria, and she also has the lead in Hattie, and I introduced her to the people for it. Mm-hmm. I'm playing a prostitute in Happy Ending, but I play a hooker with a heart of gold, and you should see the costume that Phil's picked out for me. I mean, I can't wait to show people. It's so beautiful.
All right.
And I'm also playing Bill Oberst's wife in Ken Cosentino's Camp of the Dead, which will be filmed in New York. Okay. I'm playing Stella and Mouthpiece from Longshot Productions, which will be filmed in Atlanta. I'm playing Michelle and Pastu, and that'll be filmed in Detroit. I'm playing The Outlaw Creego, which is a Western. It's one of the leads, and I'm going to learn how to really shoot a gun. I mean, I've used a gun before, but and that's going to be filmed in 2015 in Texas. I have Squeal Blood Harvest coming up the story was written by Seth Matoyer and Shannon Hilson. The screenplay was written by Mike Holtquist, and it'll be directed by James Cullen Brassack.
Okay, there's Pastu.
Oh, that's Pastu. That's the one in Detroit.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And that's the Pastu Facebook page, so please go and like it. Right. That's going to be actually directed by Robert Conrad. And that's the Robert Conrad from Wild West.
How's he doing?
He's actually doing really good.
Please give him my best, because I was a military man myself. I remember when he played as a wartime pilot for that show he did.
Okay.
Baba Black Sheep, yes. Baba Black Sheep, yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yes, actually, I haven't met him yet.
Okay.
Oh, and that's More Horror. Okay. I work for More Horror. I do interviews for Seth. I really only do interviews for films that I'm so busy these days that I do interviews for films that I work on, but I always do the films. This is Etheria Code of the Brethren. Can't really talk about the film, but it's going to be huge. And that's coming, I'm playing the Oracle in that. That's coming in 2015, but the book is out.
Right.
It's a book series aimed at young adults, and it's better than The Hunger Games. So if anybody needs a gift for a young adult, you should go and check out the Etheria series.
Wow, we told you this lady has a lot going on for Dawna Lee Heising. Remember that name?
And this is the Mockfest Film Festival, and it's run by Gil Claveria.
Okay.
And I just cast him in this film that we're doing right now. He's fantastic. He's just a wonderful person. That's where I won Best Actress for Teacher's Day. I mean, that was on my bucket list, but I was just so shocked to win it that quickly. I won that in January 2014. Mm. And I cast Gil in Natural Born Filmmaker because he's actually a college professor.
Okay.
And and this is Jared Masters, and this is Michael Curry and Mikhail Curry.
On the left.
Yeah, and Michael is a producer for Jared's films, and Mikhail is also a producer. That's Michael's son. That's when I won Best Actress, and it was for Jared's movie.
Where
Teacher's
are you putting
Day.
All these trophies at, my dear? Getting a lot of them. You also have a production company called Eye on Excellence. You're the CEO. Tell us about that, please.
Well, I always tend to think in business terms, so
okay.
I started my show Ion Entertainment on Time Warner Cable when I was still working in business and marketing. Like I said, I've started 4 marketing departments myself. I've built them from the ground up, and I've done all of the advertising, PR, all of the project management, product introductions, all of the things that go along with marketing. But my favorite is always PR. So when I started Ion Entertainment, I would work like 10-hour days for the technology companies, but I missed the business so much that I started Ion Entertainment. And then when I started that, I wanted to have a company as a backbone. So then I started Ion Excellence, and I trademarked Ion Excellence.
Okay.
And then I started working for Seth Meteor for More Horror in Hollywood. So there are 2 shows. It's Ion Entertainment and More Horror in Hollywood that I'm the executive producer of. And they're the interviews that I've done. I've done Ion Entertainment for about 9 years now.
Mm-hmm.
And so I love it, you know, but like I said, I only have time to do interviews for shows that I'm in.
Gotcha.
Right.
Gotcha.
Now.
And you have 11 clients in you, 11 or so clients in your business, your PR business?
Actually, I do have 11 clients, but they're mostly my friends. Because
okay.
I have to say, I am really good at PR. Just because I've done it so much. Mm-hmm. I've done it for companies, and then I do it for myself. Mm-hmm. So then I do it for all my friends. I'm Jared's publicist. I'm Mark's publicist. I'm Aki's publicist. If you'll see, I'm Sergio Candido's publicist, and I'm also going to be playing a role as a nurse in Visions Evolutions, which is his film coming up. I'm Chandra's publicist. I'm really, you know, once I get into a film, I end up like doing everything for publicity. So, you know, I'm listed as their publicist because I just do it all.
Oh my God. We got a few more minutes. Tell us, what are the best things you get out of what you do, the work that you do?
Well, I'm also the VP of marketing for a company called Spots Inc. Mm-hmm. And I'm doing that with another boy genius named Michael Fitchett. He's 30.
Yes.
He wrote all the software himself, so.
Okay.
Okay,
folks, can you watch this, please?
So.
Hi, I'm Alexis Nichols, one of your Actors Entertainment hosts. Here's a big hug and thank you for joining us on ActorsE Chat. We are now almost 6 million viewers and chatter strong from all over the world, and we really appreciate you. ActorsE Chat shoots live Monday through Friday, 10 a.m. Pacific Time, from the Pepper J Production Studio, below the Hollywood sign in Hollywood, California. Want to see all of today's episode or any other of our other episodes? Please visit actorsentertainment.com and put the talent's name in the search box. And go ahead and visit Actors Entertainment on imdb.com. That's the Internet Movie Database to see more than 1,200 entertainment industry professionals who have been guests on ActorsE Chat. And social media is so important. So follow Actors Entertainment on Twitter. Our handle is at ActorsEntertain. And join us on Facebook at Actors Entertainment fan page. And don't forget to like us. Those likes really help out. Stay tuned for our Actors Reporter animation, which won Best Animation at the Telly Awards. Great job in Now Media and Pepper J Productions, and terrific singing by Melissa Suzanne. And now, a special thank you to today's guest.
Hey, thank you so much. Our very special guest today is Dawna Lee Heising. Dawna Lee, can you tell us about your website?
Oh, I'd love to. This is my IMDb page.
Mm-hmm.
And I have that picture up because I'm doing Passion Show next. This is my personal website.
Wow.
You can see the book series, Etheria, and the film coming up. This is my Facebook page.
Okay.
This is my Twitter page.
Okay.
And it's Ms. Universe 2009. This is Jared's website. He's the CEO of Frolic Pictures. You can see Ballet of Blood is coming up, Deadly Punkettes, Carny Girls. We're looking for investors for both of them. And then you'll see underneath is Slink and Teacher's Day. And he's actually, like I said, he's 26 years old, but he's done 11 films, which is amazing.
Wow. Well, that's my website. They throw that up there all the time, and I thank them very much. And right there in that picture down there, that's my lady in the red. It's my mother and my oldest daughter right there, and that's my other chat. But again, Dawna Lee, we want to thank you very much for taking some time out. Glad to have you on the set today. Please come back again.
Thank you.
And bless. Say hi to Paul. Say hi to the family for us. God bless you, and keep on doing what you're doing. Thank you all, ladies and gentlemen, for joining us. We'll see you next time. Take care.
What's that? ActorsE Chat Show? Happens to be my favorite. In the morning, I want nothing but a cup of coffee, a bottle of Kahlua, six naked girls. Wait, no, that's not right. ActorsE Chat Show.
Gosh, hey, big Hollywood starlet that just happens to be walking by.
Yes?
I'm not from around here, but I want to be an actress just like you. What do I need to know?
Kid, let me tell you. Whether you're a seasoned pro or a naive newbie like you, there's one thing you need to know. To get my first job, I lived in a slum, beat out 50 other girls to play a drunk bum.
I cried.
My first agent charged me 30%.
Thanks.
Working three jobs and I couldn't pay rent. But I'm an actor.
She's an actor.
A shark gnawed my leg on a B film in Sydney. To pay for the stitches, I sold my left kidney. I finally made a union. Their rules were complex. Their piles of paperwork fogged up my specs. But I'm an actor.
She's an actor.
I'm an actor.
Rather disturbing, but what's the one thing I need to know?
Don't listen to the critics. Don't follow all the tabs. Forget that sleazy photog and the agent that's got crabs. Go to Actors Reporter.
Actors Reporter.
ActorsReporter.com. Learn the tricks and the secrets without all the sweat. An info-packed one-stop shop. It's free and on the net. Actors Reporter.
Actors Reporter.
ActorsReporter.com.
How can they help her?
Career cues, union news, makeup woes, advice from pros, insurance tips, choosing scripts, everything at your fingertips. Actors Reporter.
Actors Reporter.
Actors Reporter. ActorsReporter.com.
I just got a call back.
Gruber. Thanks for joining us on ActorsE Live Chat Show. I'm just one of your ActorsE hosts, but as you can see, I'm also the ActorsE Live video editor, which means that I'm here, even when you don't see me. ActorsE is here to chat with you Monday through Friday at 10 a.m. Pacific Standard Time, or Hollywood Time, as I like to call it. Our guests include actors, directors, producers, writers, singers, comics, and others that are all in the entertainment industry. You can see previous shows at www.actorsentertainment.com and be sure to check out our guest index to find your favorite celebrities. See you next time. I'm working.